these dates. It's the 27th. So it's February. February is going to be over soon. We have a similar format that we did a couple weeks ago, I think about a month ago actually, where we're going to do 10 exercises. We're going to do 10 reps, dropping to four. So four rounds of these 10 exercises, but inserting a specific exercise that we'll do for five reps every time. So you'll understand the format and you'll be like, oh yeah, I remember that one. So warm up first is going to be a down dog into up dog plank hop. So we'll do a little plank hop in there, get warm up our legs. And then you're gonna need your elevation. We're gonna do like a kind of crossover step up body weight, and that leg that's on the step is gonna go down into a side lunge, okay? So stepping over, opening up the hips a little bit there. This is your warm up, so you'll get those your legs twice on that one. And up dog, down dog, plank hop. When you're in the down dog, that's when you'll plank hop. All right. Another breath already. Okay.
All right, that's not good.
All right, 5 seconds with our down dog. Hopefully my timer is up. Here we go. 4 seconds, three. So I'm gonna start into my up dog. Go into down, plank hop in and out. So kind of go down a little bit of a push up. Stretch your core, stretch your calves and your shoulders, plank hop in and out. 3 seconds. All right, I'll do my right foot crossing over. Right foot's also going to laterally lunge. 3 seconds, I'm like, that's not right. All right, so crossing over, stepping up, balance. That foot comes down, and then you're gonna do a side lunge. And then you're gonna repeat. If your balance is off initially, that's normal. 10 seconds. Cross over. 3 seconds. Open up our hips. All right, back to that up to down to plank hop, going in 5 seconds. You have the whole space, Wendy. It gets so, my garage gets so messy. Not that it gets messy, but Noah starts drilling and sanding stuff, and there's like wood pieces everywhere. All right, I'm gonna do my other leg. Left foot coming over.
This one's some tighter.
Ooh, this might be this one. This on this side, this leg.
My brain needs to change.
You have to change. Yes. Left side. That's my left foot, which is not my stronger.
No.
Side. Go deep if you can in that lunge. All right, back to that up to down. Hope we get warm. I mean, I've seen colder days, but it's still cold. So I'm going down a little bit of push-up, getting that core. Down dog, stretch the calves, hop in and out. Pulling out my later one for some more windmill variations. I'm like obsessed with windmill stuff. Right, left side. And you can use dumbbells actually for pretty much everything if you needed to. Cross that leg over. And our first round will be 10 exercises, 10 reps. And inserted in between those 10 exercises, 5 swing squat swings. So I'll be using my 40 actually for most of those 5 rep exercises. All right, so obviously the first round will be us going through the exercises. We're gonna do a kneeling, we've done this. This is total, most of these are total of 10. If it's one side, I'll let you know. I don't think there's too many that are gonna be one side. So you're gonna clean, press, you're gonna look up at that weight, and you're gonna come down, you're gonna come up, clean, other side, 10 total. I'm gonna do a 25 dumbbell for this one. And who knows, maybe when the reps get less, I'll attempt something heavier. We'll see. All right, so I'm gonna start with my right. Both legs are down, clean, press, look up at that weight. We're gonna come down to our elbow, to a nice like tabletop, and then up, and then repeat on the other side. That's one rep. Look up, with control, come down. That's two. Focus on the core, so keep it tight. That's 3. Straight locked arm. 5. Use your glutes too to pull your body up. 6. And then you have those squat swings after these. For 5. 7. Functional movement. One more. All right, grab my 40 for the swings. So you start to swing. Remember, step back. Kind of have that nice sitting back on your heels. You're gonna swing and then squat swing. That's 1.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
So get that movement going. 2. 3. Good. There we go. 4. And 5. All right. Second move. We have kick through swing. So 10 total. I'm going to use my heavy kettlebell. Basically, you're behind your bell. You're going to kick through one side, kick through, popping in, and then swing. Okay, so 10 total on that. Because we didn't get enough swings on the last exercise. All right, so like kind of like bear hold. So bring the shoulder back, your arm back, that's 1. Pop it in, and then swing. And then reset it down. Squeeze the glutes. 2.
Are you sending the girls your stuff to do?
Yeah. Oh, do you? Oh, good. I was going to say, they could have came today.
They have hour. Shh. This is a nasty multiple.
I know, it's not one exercise. It's only the combination of the one exercise. And then this is this, this 5. Swing it. They're athletes though, so that's actually what they need.
Yeah.
Like multifunctional, like movements. Is this 6?
Yep.
Oh, these take a while. I'm feeling the fire. Try and get that nice back stretch.
Yeah, my legs.
My quads. This is the bear hold. Last one. All right. 40s. Okay. and back. One. Two. Three. Four. And five. All right, well, Kang, this is alternating clean. Okay, I'm gonna use the 30. For this, you can use the dumbbell too if you want. I'm gonna clean it, brace it, hinge in the good morning, sit no squat. All right. 10 total, okay. So, clean it, and then brace. We're gonna hinge, sit. So the clean is in the front, then bring the weight down. Clean on the other side, hold it, because you're gonna lean, sit. That's two. Three. Four, squeeze the glutes. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Two more. So clean it up across the body and catch it kind of. Opposite hand. One more. Squat swings. Boy. Woo! It's nice when the reps go down. This will be the hardest now. Sit back on your heels. One. Thank God for rest days. Sunday's my rest day. Four. And it's because of this workout. That's five. All right, we're on to number four. Tricep push-up, burpee, bicep curl. I'm gonna use 20. So you're gonna hold the weight into that tricep push-up. And then you're gonna come up and you're gonna do a bicep curl. 10 total. So getting some upper body, thankfully. You're popping down, tricep push-up, pop your feet in, come on up, curl, that's one. Two. Arms tucked by your side. Three. Four. Nice straight plank. Five more. Six, squeeze those biceps. Seven. Eight, two more. Don't swing the arms, okay? Control bicep curls. And 10, squat. Swing, squat, swings. Whew. Sit back. We're tight. Two. Three. Four. And five. Gently put it down. All right, we have your elevation you're going to need. This is a little another. Oh, wait, I'm not using this. I'm using 50. So what we're going to do is you're going to sit and kind of do like your deadlift, and then you're gonna come down and you're gonna clean. And then when you come down from that thing, you're gonna sit. If that makes sense, okay? I'll walk you through this first round. Don't get comfortable sitting. All right, so let's start from standing, okay? You're gonna go all the way down and lower, kind of have a little hinge position like you're doing a deadlift. You're gonna come up, then you're gonna go down, and you're gonna clean, and you're gonna go all the way back down, sit. So deadlift, and then clean, and go all the way down, sit. But in an angle, so you're getting more hinged glute. I did that wrong. Clean it, and then go all the way down to that deadlift. So you're deadlifting up first, and then you're gonna clean. But you're gonna sit with that deadlift, okay? And release. So deadlift, this is five. Clean, come all the way down, sit. Take the weight off of that deadlift. Clean it, six. All the way down. Squeeze those, come up. Clean it, seven. All the way down. Pull it up. Eight. All the way down. Pull it up. Nine. Last one. All the way down. Squeeze up. And then clean it. All right. Takes a little bit to get used to that movement. Okay. Squat swing. And then we're halfway done with this first round. That was the fifth exercise. One. Two. Three. Four. And five. Your sixth exercise, figure eight catch. I'm gonna use a lighter kettlebell, so let me show you this one. I have a big bell, so I gotta be careful when I put it around my, and I'm gonna catch it. So lighter weight. So you're gonna sit back, you're gonna bring it around, catch it, and then I think I'm doing a squat. Yeah, then I'm gonna do a squat. No, I changed this one. All right, so figure eight, around, then I'm gonna turn, and I'm gonna static lunge. Okay, this is a little bit another complicated, I'm gonna face you so you can see this. So. When I figure eight and catch, the side that I'm catching is where I'm going to turn. We'll make it simple, and then you do a static lunge. Then you come back, you're going to figure eight the other side. Catch, 10 total. Okay, so this is not 20 total. Starting with my right, I'm going to thread it around my left leg. Make sure I go for my static, okay? So bring it around, catch it, turn, and lunge. Figure out my right, catch it, turn, and lunge. Left. So around my left, swing it up, turn, three, switch, and four. Yeah, just be careful hitting. That's why I got this big bell. Like, I think this is five. Go deep in those lunges. Six. Seven. So you're wrapping around the leg at the side that you're lunging. Oh, complicated. Eight. Nine. And ten. All right. Squat swings. Five. Oh, I got a running nose. I'm good. Here we go. Hinging. One, core tight. Two, three, four, and five. All right, single arm chest press. Okay, get ready on your back for this one. I'm gonna do one weight. So you're gonna do each side 10 reps. This might be the number. And what you're gonna do is one leg's extended and the other one is the opposite knee while you're pressing. All right.
Ooh, yeah.
So when your knees, your arms down, your knees in, then you're gonna press up. Almost in that kind of hollow hold too. Position if you can do the hollow hold. So weight, knees by my chest, weight down, pressing up at the same time. One, obviously. Two, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Slowly lower, switch sides. So knee in, arms down. 1, 2, there's definitely, your body wants to move to that side of the weight. Fight it. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. All right, we got the swings.
Woo! I know you're gonna miss these swings.
That's gonna be looking good.
Oh, ab. That one's functional as well. A lot of functional stuff. Oh yeah. 1, 2. We need a strong core, right? 3, 4, and 5. All right. Dead stop Bulgarian lunges. Oh, sorry about this one. 2 weights. I'm gonna go lighter than normal, cause, or I'm gonna do like maybe do a single weight. But your one leg's gonna be elevated. I want you to come all the way down, lower the weight, and then come up. I think I'm just gonna use a single weight. And I'm gonna use a dumbbell. You can use a kettlebell if you don't want to go down as far.
That would be a good idea.
10 on each leg.
So you really want depth on this. So I just have one more time. So make sure your knee does not go beyond your toe. You're gonna lower and then pick up. 1, 2, 3. You're gonna have a little bit of a hinged position, and that's okay. That's gonna just force you to work more glutes. 5, 6, 7, 8. These are hard. There's nothing easy about these. 9. Start and make sure I'm in good position. Long arm. 1. Press up with the front heel. 3. I feel like we're getting a lot of legs today. 4. I think the other day we had a lot of upper body, so this is good. We're even things out. 6. 7. More. Oh, feeling this. And you go deep, really. And 10. Whew. All right, squat swings. Oh. Okay. Here's my 40. Don't want to grab the heavy weight. All right. Here we go. 1, 2. 3, weight in the heels, 4, and 5. All right, we have snatch. You can use a dumbbell or a kettlebell for this. So you're gonna snatch the weight up, rotational windmill, then you can either bring the weight down and do a front reverse lunge, or you can keep the arm up, front pendulum lunges. That's one rep, so 10. Total, so then we'll switch and snatch on the other side. I'm going to try and do 130 kettlebell. If I wobble, don't make fun of me. This is a lot of core, okay? Make sure you have room to do your front reverse lunge. So we're going to snatch. If you feel comfortable with kettlebell, remember it's kind of like, it's hard to explain. I always say practice that high pull first. Once you get that, then it becomes a little, because it's a, look at the wrist. Up, I'm probably not going to explain that right, but there's people on YouTube that have better explanations. However, once you get used to it, it just becomes more fluid, okay? or just use a dumbbell. All right, here we go. And then you're gonna look up your weight, and it's just a hinging position, coming down, and then coming up. And then I'm gonna go with the same side, front lunge, reverse lunge, and then slowly bring it down, and then repeat on the other side. Windmill. So this is a lot. I mean, this exercise is gonna take a while. Front to reverse. That's two. Actually, you want it on, so you can just swing it. Actually, you can swing and switch if you want, so I'll try that as well. So coming down, front lunge, reverse lunge. So bringing down, I'm gonna swing, switch. If you're not doing that, just do the dumbbell version. Bring it from the ground. So 10 total. Swing down, swing, switch, and then snatch it up. Front, reverse, and that's five. Feel that nice core oblique movement. Front, reverse, we got four more. Good, we have two more. I felt like that one whacked my arm. Oh, front lunge. Sick, burning bell. Balance. I lost my focus. So I'm gonna switch. Someone had bruises from doing snatches last week, and that like does happen. I think you have to get rest. Used to the movement, but I feel like I just whacked my. All right. Swing, squat. We have one move after this. And we're going with these. One, two, three, four, and five. Is B stance, okay? So you're gonna hold, I'm gonna hold a lighter weight. You can use this with a dumbbell as well. So I'm gonna hold it like this, and I'm gonna B stance, staggered squat. Actually, this weight's too fat. And I'm just gonna do a halo, okay? We'll do five on one leg, and then we'll switch and we'll do five on the other leg. I'm gonna do a dumbbell. Just awkward, bringing that around my head. So one foot's back. You're gonna go in a deep squat, and then when you come up, you're gonna halo five and five. So deep squat. Two, if you can't do this because you have like shoulder issues, maybe just do, or don't do the halo. Four, last one on this side. Switch the stagger, deep squat. And then the other direction, I think this is the other direction. Maybe it wasn't, all right. Just make sure you're always alternating, or that's the right way. Three. One more. And five. Luckily that was a quicker one, last time squat swing. And then we do eight reps and everything. Let me change this exercise. One, two, three, four, and five. All right, we're done. We got eight reps now. And your five rep exercise is a ground, tapping the ground overhead. Every time you tap the ground though, it's Especially we'll start overhead. So you're gonna go down to the ground, plank hop, plank in, and then repeat. All right, so for five. Woo, all right, starting with kneeling, click through. I'm sorry, kneeling, clean and press. Half windmill, I did 25s, I'm gonna stick with my 25s. Alternate, this will be 8 total. So we're gonna both legs are down on the ground. Clean and press, alternating, and then going to bed. Woo, rotating passion, half windmill. So clean, press, look up at that weight. With control, come down. One. Two. Three. Four. Do a little pause. We're down. We have four more. Those ground overhead, I'm gonna use one heavy weight. I'm gonna use my 35.
And both hands are on it for that plank hop.
Last one here. So I'm gonna play this move a little quicker since we know the moves. Alright. Got my long weight. So starting overhead. Alright. So we're gonna come down and tap and hop out. One. Two, use your core. Three, four, and five. All right, kick through with a swing for eight. Two kick throughs, one swing. All right,
stand back. Make sure my weights are not
in the way of the kick throw. All right, in your bear, hold. Kick both sides. Pop it behind and swing. One. That was four. We got four more left. Swing hard. And your quads are on fire. And that's it. Overhead to ground with the plank up. Starting overhead if you can. Tap it down. Hop it. One. Two. We have alternating a clean of the Kang, 8 total. Clean in, brace it. Kang is just a good morning into a squat. So clean it up. All right. Hinge, sit, and then reverse. Two. Three. on depth here on that squat. And nice flat back. Two more. And feel that nice stretch in your hamstrings. Weight comes up. Brace it. Hinge. Squat. And reverse. Ground to overhead. Plank hop. One, power it up. Two, three, four, and five. Tricep push-up burpee with a bicep curl braid. So that's a close push-up. When you're doing your burpee. So we're taking those weights up. One. Two. Three. Straight body, don't lean forward. Two more. Seven. All right, ground overhead, plank hop. One, two, three, four, and five. All right, we have a seated deadlift into a clean for eight. Using my quad bell. So pick it up and you're gonna lower, hinge like you're doing a deadlift, but lower all the way down. Then pick it up and then clean it. One, two. So hinge position with the deadlift. Three. Use your heels, so your glutes and your hamstrings are feeling it. Four, to press up, okay, on these movements. Five, two, and one. Surprise. Six, and it's a full all the way down. Seven on the deadlift, so you release your hands a little bit. And eight. Overhead.
Five. I sing that song.
Which one was on?
The holy song.
The holy song. Which one is that? Can you think?
But he's like,
oh, ground control. Do you know? Judy would be singing it for us.
Yeah.
But she's in Nashville, so. Maybe there's music she can listen to.
She's probably on stage.
Who knows what the situation is there.
Stealing someone's guitar.
She will find a stage. This is my sister. Will find a stage. Okay. And she will have no problem going up and singing with people. Random people.
Oh my God.
Figure eight catch. Oh, gonna stick to my 40 here. 30. Yes, she will find a stage.
That's awesome.
People to sing with. I don't know if anyone knows Teddy Thompson. She wanted to sing and sang with him. Oh. Yeah. I think he's a big deal, but. All right. We're gonna figure eight, rotate. One. Two, we just have eight total. Make sure you really move that weight, okay? Kind of have to have a little bit of momentum to catch it. Four. Now that we know the moves, I feel like everything's moving a little bit faster and smoother.
Yeah.
Five. Six. Two more. Seven. And eight. Look at that. That was fast. Ground. Control. Okay. Right overhead. Ground overhead. No, I'm gonna have that sound in my head.
Sorry. It's okay, sometimes that's good.
Oh, my daughter, when she used to run cross country, it was always a song that she would have in her head to help her get through it.
Yeah.
True. Instead of thinking how long you have to run.
Yeah, she just, it's funny. She was like, I think in like third grade. She was like, that song singing in my head. One more.
Cute.
And now she hates cross country, so. Just PTSD from it. All right. Single arm chest press. Put that knee in.
Oh, let me rest. Those 10 were hard.
Sawdust is all over my knees. So opposite leg. One, two, three, four, five. Six, seven, and eight. Switch sides. One, two. Do whatever you want with that other hand. Three. Don't leave it on the ground. Four. Don't cheat. Five. Even though your body wants to rock to the side of the way it is. Six, seven, and eight. All right.
Ground overhead.
We got three moves left in this round.
It's taking a while, I know. I'm sorry.
Here we go. Ground. One. Two. Three. We got dead stop. Bulgarian is next. Four. And five, eight and eight, single weight, dead stop. Just make sure you're set up safely. My elevation is really high, so it's 18 inches. I don't like it this high, but that's all I got right now. One, two, three. Four, five, six, seven, one more. I thought time was hard. It's just as hard.
Yeah.
Even when I got to the fourth rep, I'm like, oh, you know, I'll have to do four at some point. That was hard. One. Two, I'm sorry, my nose is like, it's cold. Three. Four. I mean, it's not cold. I'm not cold now, but it's cold outside. Six. Two more. Seven. Last one. And eight. Ground. That song. Here we go.
It's something that keeps your heart up the whole time.
What, this exercise?
Just every, yeah.
This whole workout. We don't stop.
It's like a steady, consistent.
It's, yeah. I should check my heart rate, like, when I'm done the workout.
Yeah.
And see if it does go up and down. I mean, this is all weights, so it's not like, you know, we're running. Whew. Alright, two more moves. We got that snatch, windmill, pendulum.
8 total.
Okay, I want to make sure I focus on my balance. I know this one takes a while. Stand back. Okay. Snatch. I'm gonna do that windmill. Same side. Forward lunge.
Oh, forward, yeah.
If you don't like the forward lunge though, you just do one reverse with a static. It's an option. Oh wait, I did that wrong already. Swing and switch. Swing. Switch to snatch.
Getting a lot on this one. You're getting shoulders, back, core, and legs. We have two more. Locked arm straight. Stand squat with the halo. Four. And five. Stick to my dumbbell. B stands, four on each side. One foot's back. So deep squat. Halo around. One. This round. Four, switch. One. Two. Three, last one. And four. Ground, overhead, last time. Then we move on to six reps. Those
five. Overhead, knees. Last one. I know, right? You figured, like, what did I say in the beginning? Like, I want to train for it. Where are you before the tournament? That's gross. No, you just were tired. So it's not going to happen. Overhead. Okay, so get the weight. Hold it overhead. You're just going to do 5 minutes. One. Two. Three. Four. And five. See, easy.
Kick for a swing.
Not easy. All right, six total. Just clear my space a little bit. All right, six. I'm gonna start on the other side. One. Two. Two more. We got this. Last one. Six. The nice thing about this round is you're going to have to do that one more time. Overhead, knees, for four reps. I'm lifting my head like that hollow hold. You don't have to do that if you don't feel comfortable. Make this exercise work for you. Two, three, four, and five. All right, that Kang with your kettlebell, cleaning it. Six total. Okay, so clean it and then brace it. Hinge, sit, one, two, three, four. Takes more energy to get down and up in this one. Two, three, four, and five. All right, we are on to our tricep push-up with the burpee. Well, it's a burpee with a bicep curl. For six. Deep breath. Three. Four. deadlift, and then clean it up. One. Two. So separate the two movements. Three. Four. One more. And six. Right overhead. We're halfway with this round. One, two, three, four. Six more on the other leg. on each movement separately. Stance position, two, three, work those abs, and five. Last move, and four reps. All right, you guys, we got this. One leg back, squat, up, just three, one, two, and basically one foot's up, and then you're going to use the actual same hand as the side you're going to kneel, okay, so you're going to five and five, we did them last week. All right, kneeling, clean and press, four total. Let's get through this, okay? We're a little over an hour already.
Are we?
Yeah, and last time we did this, it took an hour. So I think it's just all my combination moves that made this a little bit longer. Two, core tight, three, four, and five. All right, on to that kick throw. Four. The swing. One. One, two, get that weight up. Three, four, five, and switch. One, two, three, four, and five. We got the clean Kang squat, four total. Hinge, squat, my legs. I'm gonna be sore tomorrow. It's a good thing I didn't work legs yesterday. Two more. two, three, four, five. All right, we're on to tricep push-up. Into bicep curl, four reps. One. These are the only burpees today, guys, so about that. Swings. One, two, three, four, and five. So down. We got that deadlift box one. One. Flat back. Three. And four. Three swings. And then we're halfway there. One, two, three, four, and five. One, two, three, four, and five. Okay, great catch. Four total. That's static. So that should be great. Catch it. Rotate. Static. Two. Two more. Three. Four. Swings. One, we got Bulgarians, two, three, four, and five, for four, four reps, one, two, don't cheat it since we're at the end. Get through it. Ooh. Other side. One, two, three, and four.
Swing in, swing in.
Ugh. Nice. Okay. Two moves.
two, three, four, and five. Snatch windmill. Four total. Alright, I'm gonna move this out of the way because I don't do this. Lunge, swing, switch, all right, two more, already losing my balance. Wrist guards you can get when you're doing kettlebell stuff, just because of the banging. When I first started learning how to use kettlebells, it was hard. Like, you would bang, like, the clean and stuff. Yeah. Alright, last move. Beast stance with the halo. Two on each side. This is going to go so quick. One. And two. And switch. Go deep. One. Finishing up with our swings. And two. This is it. A little bit longer than I wanted it. Thought it would be like an hour, like the last one. Here we go. One, two, three, four, and five. One. Two, three, four, and five. Oh, all right. Kind of long, but I definitely had a lot of function in that workout. I hope you guys enjoyed that. Don't forget to stretch. Get outside if you can, if you have any sunlight or sun. We have rain today, so vitamin C, vitamin D, make sure you get it. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And that's it, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye! That wasn't like a high calorie.